Now we're joined by Webster Griffin Tarpley. He's an author and historian. Dr. Tarpley, thank you for joining us on World News. How long will NATO continue its air raids? More importantly, how much longer will Muammar Gaddafi, do you think, stay in power?
I think Gaddafi is destined to stay in power for quite a while. I think he's likely to view the fall of people like Sarkozy, Cameron, maybe Obama, and maybe some others. NATO would like to continue their attacks, but the problem they have is that they're going to run up against this mid-September deadline that's built into the United Nations Security Council resolution. At that point, they will need a new resolution, and I'll be very surprised if Russia decides to put more egg on its face by not vetoing such a resolution. You also have to look at the fact that the coalition is falling apart. As of right now, Libya time, Norway has dropped out of the coalition. Over here, we've got Anne-Marie Slaughter, who is a leading hawk, one of the first advocates for the bombing under humanitarian cover, now saying it's time to compromise. She's basically admitting defeat. As a result of the death of Yunus, there are now so many questions about the terrorist faction fights among the top honchos of the rebel council there in Benghazi that the British press is saying that Cameron won't be able to continue. Berlusconi says that he didn't want to do it. He was forced to do it by Obama, and he was talked into it by President Napolitano of Italy, who, interestingly enough, is an old communist who's now become a warmonger for NATO. So if you look at this coalition, it's in total disarray. One other thing, if you're following the U.S. House of Representatives in this budget fight, when that gets over with, you're going to have a lot of mad Tea Party Republicans looking for an issue that they can use against Obama. I have an idea, Libya and Obama's violation of the War Powers Act might be that issue.
Well, Dr. Tarpley, you say that he's going to stay in power for a longer time. Do you think the revolutionaries can capture Brega, and is that the key point holding Gaddafi in power? If they capture, will that cause a turning point?
Again, I can't accept this terminology because people working for NATO and the CIA and Al-Qaeda, certainly not revolutionaries. The Libyan revolution is what's been in power for the past 40 years. I don't think a few hundred yards or a few kilometers here or there is going to make much difference. If you've been in Tripoli, as I have, you just see that there's a solid base of support for Gaddafi. We've now got NATO bombing the television station. I'm horrified. These are people that I know. You've got a guy there called Dr. Shakir. He's known as the Larry King of Libya with his late night interview program. I was honored to be his guest a little bit more than a month ago. Now that's declared terrorism. NATO now says that a peaceful television broadcast is terrorism and they get to kill the people involved. I really wonder whether Western journalists want to go down that path because some Libyan television journalists have been killed. This is now NATO declaring international anarchy. They can kill anybody they want to. That's the kind of dangerous situation out of which larger wars have been known to grow.
Well, Dr. Tarpley, as you say, NATO declares anarchy. I think if the U.S. wants to help Libya, it can overthrow Gaddafi's regime quickly. Why are they allowing these innocent civilian deaths to continue, and how long will this continue?
I don't see any way the United States could overthrow Gaddafi. I think that's much harder to do, as we've found out. NATO has been trying to eliminate him physically as hard as they could, and they have failed. And I think the attack on the television station is an example of NATO lashing out as they realize that defeat, actual defeat, political defeat, and the collapse of their coalition is staring them right in the face, because the center of gravity of the attacking forces is the attacking coalition. The only thing you can do beyond that is a ground invasion, which is specifically forbidden by the UN Security Council resolution. And if you want to see Obama impeached, watch that. It'll go very fast if he tries to send the Marines into Libya. The place is, in a certain way, an armed camp. There are 1 to 2 million Kalashnikovs in the hands of average people. There's a tribal organization which is made to order for guerrilla warfare. I can't think of any place that would be more difficult to invade than Tripoli and its environs, and that's based on firsthand experience.
Well, thank you for joining us, Dr. Tarpley. That was Webster Griffin Tarpley. He's author and historian. joining us on World News to give us the latest from his analyst, his point of view from Libya.